Child, hold. Savior is born. Whoa.
Thank you. Christmas is coming. The rich are getting fat, the ozone layer is growing thin, and anxiety levels are sky high, so there's that. So many people have gone this year. Wars, a pandemic, protests, attacks, the information in the news is overwhelming to say the least. So we switch it off and keep on prepping for our Christmas feast. Crisis in the Middle East, click. Jingle bells. School shootings, click. Rocking around the Christmas tree. Famine, natural disasters, gang violence, another missing woman, click. What a wonderful world. I look at festive holiday cards and all I can think of is my nan who died and I didn't get to say goodbye, but don't worry about it, no. Really, I don't want to put it on you. You know what? Turn on the Christmas special, grab a little, a lot of mulled wine, and that'll do. That'll do the trick. And that's what Christmas can feel like, right? A trick? Just shoving down reality under all that glittery plastic, let the festivities commence. Roll in old Saint Nick, Father Christmas, the man himself. And don't forget an elf on the shelf. As long as we don't stop, it'll be fine. Go on then, more mulled wine. More presents, more parties, more songs, more stories, more carols, more candy, more cheer. That's all we ordered here. Reality can stay away. Doesn't it know we're on holiday? What a lovely snow globe moment. That school of thought has full-time enrollment, but it's a trick. And we're the fools, perpetrators of pandering and victims alike, because it's the same old things that run through my head as I lay awake at night. I spend money on gifts when I already know I can't make ends meet. I'm buying booze and chocolate when I've barely got enough to eat. I've got deadlines and I'm behind, so I work when everyone's gone to sleep. It's a lot, but I'm afraid to stop, because what will happen if I pause to breathe? But at least if I'm working, I'm distracted and the anxiety's at bay. At least if I'm busy, no big questions come out to play. If the burnout doesn't get me, then a global virus will. And my medication's not helping, because you can't produce a pill that stops the world from ending, from splintering as we crash at the bottom of this hill in a ball of smoke and ash. Oh, but they tell me you're Jesus. I suppose you know something of hills. Golgotha, where's it where you died 33 years before? You were cozied up inside the womb of a young virgin girl. Surprise. You're going to be a mom. The Son of God has come. Merry Christmas, and what a mighty plan. To stoop and be a man, but what does that have to do with where I am in a world of somehow simultaneous decadence and decay? Could this man Jesus really come and make a better way in a global climate resembling rubble? People troubled by unprecedented time, sabotaged by sickness of body, heart, and mind. Could there be hope of a guiding light? Like the star above the manger that night of all the voices telling me my virtues and sins. Could the word of a boy born in Bethlehem unburden me from the darkness within? Could it be true that something from the shepherds, angels, donkeys, and hay, that something from the nativity could change the world today in place of fear, good news, and great joy for everyone? Because when Mary had her baby, the savior of the world had come, the rescuer of all mankind. His sacrifice transcending time to change the story, theirs, yours, and mine. Is that what it's about this Christmas time?
Enters the scene. A mother embraces the face of her God. A father is cuddling the king.
Long, long ago on a hillside, a choir of angels rejoice. The sky full of songs for the hope that's begun. A chorus of comfort and joy.
Singing glory, glory. Hallelujah, glory in the highest. Glory, glory, hallelujah, glory in the highest.
Bring your offering to the baby king. bring your hearts again, bring her everything. The center of Christmas is here, Christ is born.
How shall we spend our December? Will we believe the good news? Will we believe there is hope for this world? Oh, join in the song if you do.
Sing glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory in the highest. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory in the highest. Bring your offering to the baby king. Bring your hearts again. Bring your everything. The center of Christmas is here. Christ is born. All of history, all the prophecies, leading up to Him, leading us to Him. The center of Christmas. Oh, come, let us adore Him.
With the angels.
Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory in the highest. 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 Bring your offerings to the baby king. Bring your hearts again. Bring your everything. The center of Christmas is here. Christ is born. All of history, all the prophecies, leading up to Him, leading us to Him. The center of Christmas. So come, let us adore Him.
Oh, come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel that mourns in lonely exile here, until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou rod of Jesse, shall come to thee, O Israel.
Israel. Rejoice,
rejoice.
Thank you.
For many of us, 2021 has been a year of difficulties, like the year before. It's definitely been a season of pain and challenge in all kinds of ways. I suppose there will be exceptions. Some of us will feel we've kind of escaped some of the more tangible problems. We might feel that we're fairly comfortable. We're kind of prosperous. We're just getting through the difficulties that society is hitting. But under the surface, under the skin, we will all be, in different ways, struggling with questions all the time. I think there are questions of disappointment. Is this really everything that I hoped that my life would be? Questions of regret. Would it be possible to go back and start again from somewhere? Did I go wrong at a certain point? Maybe questions that go further still into a sense of guilt or shame, stuff that we regret on a profound level. We know there are things in our past that feel like stains, feel like debts that need to be paid off and cleared away. We know there's just stuff in our lives. And then there's fear. We might not show it much on the surface, but we worry about the future. We worry about what it might bring. And then the ultimate worries of what does it come to? Where is it all going? What about death? These are the kind of realities of human existence that year by year, Christmas by Christmas, we find ourselves facing. It seems to be part of our very family tree, something that we've inherited as ordinary human beings just by being part of the species, part of the family. We also, I think, can't help a sense that we weren't meant for this. We were meant for something greater. We were meant for something more noble. We were meant for glory. The Bible talks about that. It talks about God's intention to bring us to destiny, to glory. Think of it like this, like if you've seen a huge redwood tree, like one of those in the forests in California, one of those magnificent evergreens that just seems to go on forever, towering above the landscape. Maybe that's a picture of what we were intended to be as humanity, climbing higher, going to greatness. And yet what we really seem to inherit is more like a Christmas tree, cut off short and covered over with tinsel, covered over with decorations, you know, somehow getting away with looking in our domesticated situation as though we're kind of happy, kind of jolly, covered in glitter, covered in some kind of Christmas array, but actually cut off from our life source, cut off from purpose, dead spiritually, and even dying physically. This is the way the Bible actually talks about our circumstances. It sets it up in stark terms. We weren't meant to live such lives of regret, guilt, shame, fear. We were meant for glory, but we've been brought by our own wrongdoing to this cut-off condition. But what we can celebrate is the God who became one of us, the God who joined us in our horrendous condition. The Bible talks about humanity as having purpose. What is man that you are mindful of him, it says, or the son of man that you care for him? You made him a little lower than the angels. You've crowned him with glory and honor, putting everything in subjection under his feet. But what we do see is humanity reduced to guilt, shame, fear, sorrow. But what God has done is he's become one of us, and he's faced all of our troubles. He faced them down one after another. You read the stories of how he dealt with the challenges, sickness, guilt, shame, how he dealt with the troubles that surrounded him. He dealt with all kinds of enemies. Even the forces of nature seemed to come under his control. And then he had to face the greatest enemy of all, because in choosing to be born, he was choosing to die. But what Jesus did in his death, he did for all of us. He died a godforsaken death. Didn't have to. We had to. We were the ones that had chosen death. But he actually chose it instead of us. And he, in his death, took on our worst enemy of all and then rose up in glory. He's defeated our greatest enemy. He's won for us. One of my favorite memories of 2021 was England versus Germany in the Euros. When Raheem Sterling put in his goal, the whole nation seemed to rise up as winners. We'd won. Of course we hadn't won. We weren't anywhere near the ball, not even at the stadium, most of us. But because he'd won, we'd won. Because he put in the winner, we felt the victory. At Christmas, we celebrate the one who is a champion, a victor for us. He came and did what we couldn't do. He did it for us. And he's triumphed over our greatest enemies. And he offers us now his Father. He offers us now relationship with him. The Bible says he's not ashamed to call us brothers and sisters. So we are offered that kind of friendship with the God who came to redeem and restore us.
Hey, well, good evening. Welcome to Emmanuel. Many of you have been on different paths, different journeys to get to this evening. Some of you have been walking with Jesus for years. Some of you, this is the first time you've been in a church building for years. We are here to celebrate the man, Jesus Christ. We're going to sing some songs, some carols written about Jesus. I want to invite you, let's draw near to him. Raise a hand in faith. Lift a hand in worship, in belief. Enjoy. Some of you, if this is newer to you, my biggest prayer for you tonight is that you would get to know the person of Jesus, the Son of Man who comes into our humanity, brings his grace, his truth. So let's stand together. We're going to sing a great hymn together. Hark the herald, angels sing.
Glory to the newborn King.
can take your seats. Let's pray, shall we? Jesus, in the busyness of December and on the tail end of a global pandemic, of all the strain on relationships and family, for many, maybe a great joy, for others, just it's been an absolute battering. Thank you right now, we can come to the Prince of Peace. And so Jesus, we turn to you right now. Thank you that you said, come to me, all who are heavy laden, burdened, I will give you rest for your souls. And so God, in this moment, we just bring ourselves, bring our stress, our burdens, our worries, our concerns. And Jesus, the Prince of Peace, we come to you. So right now, would you come with your peace? Spirit of Jesus, would you come and lift the stress of life? Come and bring rest for our souls. Right now, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
We're going to sing a song right now about the hope that we have in Christ. Let's draw near to this Jesus. Let's sing, Hope is Here.
Making a way. found its redemption in Christ, the newborn King. Angels rejoice at the birth of our hope, Emmanuel, 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 Emmanuel. Hail the Holy One, humbled and helpless all for us. Hope is here, let us adore Him. This is our
Let's take our seats together, shall we? You know, this Son of Man didn't stay in heaven. Christmas is about God becoming flesh, becoming a human being, becoming a man with a physical body. The suffering of humanity, the difficulty, He entered right into it. He's tasted the gutters of pain and suffering. Not just that, all of the evil things that have happened on earth, He takes upon Himself. For we just sung this line, born for salvation on a cross. This is what Jesus came to do, not just become a person, a human being, to connect with you, but to actually take away the sin from you. I will take it upon myself on a cross. I want to ask you a question. Do you know Him? Are you standing as one who, I've had my sins forgiven? Or are you struggling within with the darkness, with your own sense of shame, knowing deep down you haven't got what it takes? Friend, this year, this December, Jesus has come down to bring life and light and forgiveness, and to bring restoration to your humanity. He didn't even just die on a cross. He rose again to redeem, to restore, to bring dignity to you, that you could walk as one known by God, loved by God. And so I want to give you an opportunity, if you're here this evening, you're listening to these words, to come to know Jesus for yourself. If you're here tonight saying, yeah, I want to know this Son of Man, I want my sins forgiven. Yeah, that's me. I fear death. We've been singing about this tonight. Even the fear of death, Jesus can take away and bring assurance of a life in eternity with Him. If you'd like that today, I'm going to pray a simple prayer. I want to ask you just to pray that in your heart with me. So we just close our eyes across this room. Pray this prayer with me. Jesus, I come to you with darkness, emptiness, and I acknowledge I don't have what it takes. Jesus, forgive my sin. Jesus, take away my shame. Jesus, I'm sorry for the mistakes that I've made, for the foolish choices, for the shameful thoughts, and I come to your cross. Please forgive me. I believe you died for me. I believe in life in Jesus. And today, as best as I can, I choose to put my faith not in myself anymore, but in the person of Jesus Christ. Just in this moment, if you've prayed that prayer for the first time, why don't you just put up your hand? Just while every eye is closed, just put your hand in the air, just as a way of saying, Jesus, I'm in. Thank you, guys. You can put your hands down. Praise God. Praise God for you. Jesus is here. He's changed so many lives. And three more people today have said, yes, I'm in. Let's just open our eyes together. Haven't these guys made a good decision? Yeah. At the end of this next song, I'm going to give you just some next steps just to help you with your journey walking with Jesus. You know, when you know Jesus in your life, it changes everything. He turns things upside down and brings joy and peace that no pain can shake. So let's adore him together. We're going to sing our final carol together today. Oh, come, let us adore him. Let's stand together. Let's sing this. What an incredible Savior the Son of Man is, who comes into our lives, into our darkness, redeems and restores. He's been drawing people across the nations to worship him. This has been a journey of different people, even coming to this moment right now, to Jesus, the Son of Man who changes everything. If you have prayed that prayer earlier, said, Jesus, I want to follow you. I'm turning away from myself. I've got a great next step for you. As a church, we run something called the Alpha Course. It's a really simple connection with other people in the same place where you can just learn and ask questions about the Christian faith. Bring your criticisms, your concerns, your questions in a really safe environment with other people and just learn a bit more about Jesus and about the Bible. What about you watching this? As I said, this is a journey of different people gathering together to be together. As a church, as Emmanuel, we meet all across this city, different locations. And this December, we've got loads of different Christmas services like this one. I want to invite you, don't spend this December on your own. Come and meet a community. Do you know what? We're just normal people that have met an extraordinary God. If you've got questions about the Christian faith, you'd like to know more, I would love to invite you. Come to one of our Christmas services right below this video. We've posted links of things that are going across the city. Even if you're not in this city, the great city of Brighton, we've got things going on in Amsterdam, Bath, Berlin, other places. There might be a city near you, but I want to invite you, come and find a community. Come and get to know Jesus more. Maybe the Alpha Course is the right next step for you. Guys, have you had a good evening this evening? Well, it's not over yet. We've got mulled wine and mince pies. Fantastic. So good to have you here. Go and help yourself to some mulled wine mince pies. We look forward to seeing you at one of our Emmanuel Christmas services this December. God bless you, and we'll see you soon. Good night.
Chose to love me just as I am, and there is nothing that I can do that he won't understand. Hi, I'm Zoe. I'm grateful that God didn't leave me to walk through the darkest valley of chronic illness alone. Even though at times it felt like it, I know he never left.
I'm Will, and I'm so grateful that God isn't a distant God, but he's a close, intimate God who walks alongside us.
My name is Arnold and I run a business, and sometimes when running a business it can be so difficult when you're trying to make a decision because you want to try and get as much money as possible, sometimes at the expense of other people. But Jesus was somebody that was so caring and so loving. Once I came to witness that and his reliance on God, I started to realize that I could be like that as well. Jesus allows me to make decisions for the benefit of other people without necessarily thinking, I just need to get so much for myself. He is the one that provides all of my needs, and I've just seen that so much in him, and that's great.
Hi, I'm Ethel Savander. What I love about Jesus is that I can talk to him and relate with him. As a human being, whatever I'm feeling or thinking, he relates, because he's lived as a person, as a man here on earth. He knows my emotions, he knows fear, he knows worry, he knows everything I go through. So I just love to talk to him throughout the day and share my life with him.
Hi, my name's James, and Jesus coming to earth means that I have a best friend, a best brother who walks with me through everything.
Hi, I'm Larissa, and I'm blown away with how gentle God is. He sees me and he takes me with all of my rough edges, and he smooths over it all with his grace and love.
Hey, I'm Ella. So I get a lot of pain in the night, which can feel really isolating. But one thing I know is I am never alone. God always has me. He sees it and he holds me up.
Hi, I'm Susie, and I'm so grateful for that because Jesus became a man. He is utterly able to sympathise with me in my weakness. He knows what it is to be needy, to be dependent, and he moves towards me in my weakness to help me in the day to day.
Oh come Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, that mourns in lonely exile here, until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou rod of Jesse, and be yourself a king.